Okay, so hello friends. Today I'll teach the very special subject in great industry of network marketing. This subject is duplication, and it will be easy steps that will lead you to success in networking business. So let me inform you that today is the special day when we open a training for Baltic region community that speaks both languages, Russian and English language. So today we will combine a presentation in English language with slides in Russian language. Okay, so the following training we plan fully in English language only. So please listen carefully to English presentation if you cannot follow it on slides, and you will get all the information anyway. So my name is Kęstutis Gudynas. Some friends call me in a shortened way Kes, and I'm expert in blockchain and cryptocurrency industry, sales and MLM marketing trainer and practitioner. And the reason I'm giving this training is because I have been in this industry for around 4 years and succeeded to get among top 100 earners in a company with 500,000 partners. So I have accumulated some experience that might be useful to you, and I will share in my duplication training. Okay, so this is an opening part, and we will do more on the way. So when we only start talking of how we build business on multi-level marketing, we get into first strategic question. Shall we build wide or deep structure? By choosing a wrong strategy, you could miss the success. So we start from first tip and give you the right understanding of what is the way to build a big and successful business in network marketing. You must follow those principles of building both wide and deep structure. And you must pay the main attention to the first 3 lines down in your structure. If you miss to build deep structure, so no one will be doubling your work. And if you set no duplication system in your team, so when someone from your team leaves business, his people might leave as well. Reason they have no skills to build a team alone unless you teach them the right principles. That's why it's so important for your system is set to build 3 levels down. You train your first line team, for example, first 5 or 10 people in your first line, how to train their first line. Okay, once again, 5 or 10 person each, and how to follow up and help to pass this system down. So we set a system of 4 steps to start with: invitation, webinars or presentation, follow-up call, and follow-up meeting, closing the sale, and supporting the duplication. For every sponsor, for every sponsor, we have 7 obligations, 7 steps that you need to learn yourself and teach your team. First, setting the tasks. Second, list of names. Third, time planning. Fourth, calling to meeting. Fifth, presentation. Six, following up. Seven, handling the objections and the further support. When you set tasks, you need not to miss some important factors. So we use word SMART to remember it. How do we set tasks and the system SMART? Specific, it means it must be clear of who will do what, why they do it, where and when they do it, what and with whom something will happen next. So that's the first one, specific, okay? Measurable, everything you put in your tasks, you must be able to measure. So it must be a concrete, okay? A task set in your list. Achievable. It is very important, so the tasks that are set, everyone would believe internally that those tasks are achievable. They must be nice to reach them, okay? But they must be achievable. Person must believe it is achievable, because if it is out of a personal belief, anyone in your downline, they just wouldn't go for this target. It has to be relevant, and it has to be timed, set for a certain period of time. Okay, so for tasks, we do planning in different time frames. It's starting from a long term, which is 5 years and more. It can be 10 years, it can be 15 years, okay? You set it with your teammate. Then you go down to 1 year, to 6 months plan, 1 month plan, 1 week plan, and daily planning. So it's very important from the long perspective, you cut down to smaller pieces and you do planning for as little as 1 day. Take your time to understand what is really important to your partner. Once you have the answers, write it all down on paper. Make one copy for your partner and take a copy for yourself. You need to know and have tasks of your partners, so you would be able to remind them not to miss on their tasks and dreams. Okay? Tasks are dreams of someone else. So once you have it, you can put it even in your phone, and by calling the person, you know what dream you have to remind them. So you will become a partner who will help to bring those dreams through. Okay, this is very important, by reaching set targets. If you want to achieve your dreams, you must set them as your goals. First months, you would usually spend learning and training with your sponsor, and some would apply to all new members. So when you start, set the tasks to do first 10 sales. This will help you to reach first rank to become leader. Always make sure you know the rank system in detail. Then set following steps to go one rank up. Okay, so that's to masters. You climb up helping your partners to reach their first rank. Your partners reach leader, you become master. That's the goal, okay? From your first rank, your full orientation, your full focus goes on your team. So you help your team grow, it means you grow up automatically. This is very, very important. So for this, if you follow up with my trainings, if you ask for it, I will later give you a special extra training on effective strategy that helps to grow you in ranks. This might also be important. Okay, second step or second month, you would work with your team. You would teach them and train them to duplication skills. This will help your partners to grow fast in networking business. So once more, you will get trained yourself and become a leader in your team. Then you teach a minimum 3 partners to become leaders, and this way you go to a next rank, rank of masters, and support further duplication down in your team. People you know is one of the key factors to your success. That is important, but also important that there are many ways how to expand your contact list, so you would never get short of people. This is important. This is the skill you need to build in yourself. So your contact list is important factor for your faster success, but anyway, you need to build skills to expand your contact list on daily basis. Contacts that we already have is best. Okay, we do not ignore them. It's best to start with. If we do not use it, we harm our business ourselves. Okay, we do not want to be enemy to ourselves. So remember those people, one day when you successful, they might get angry if you did not call them and offer them opportunity you found for yourself. So best way to avoid this misunderstanding is not to miss anyone you know. Remember that the way you look makes impression and attracts. So make sure you have and use business cards, notes, books, pens, pins, and other material you can get the logo of company. This gives the best first impression to people and attracts to business. Okay, I'm back on. Sorry for this connection. We shall continue further. So what are the starting steps to your success? First, create your contact list. Second, group your contacts. Write 1-3 sentences saying what good you know about any person you put in your contact list. This will be very important for you later on. This will help you when you talk to them, and this will also help your sponsor to help you to follow up with them. Okay, this is very, very important tip. When you make a list, you add 1-3 sentences like compliments you could write about that person. Once you do it, it will be much easier for you to do all the following steps. So next, make phone calls to all of your contacts, starting from the closest ones to you. How do you remember and how do you not miss any of your contacts that you have? So you will soon remember how many people you met in your life. That might expand your list a lot. And you go by a list of family and relatives, people you had sport activities with, people you traveled with or met during traveling, social network friends and contacts, people you met in different trainings, your ex-work colleagues, current work colleagues, schoolmates, people met in theaters, cinemas, and on hobby activities like concerts, doctors, lawyers, bankers, travel friends, restaurant, kindergarten, school, colleges, universities. If you write down this entire list, your contact list will be very long, usually 300-500 people. Okay, people do not imagine they have so much contacts before they start really thinking about it and working on contact list. The very best is to start on your family. Get your skills and training on them. Do not go straight away to most rich and most business-minded people you have in your list. Get skills and confidence in yourself before you go to them. So family is usually the one that loves you the most, so you can also do the most mistakes with them. And they will accept it, okay? No matter they come or not, but they will give you the best opportunity for practice. This is very important, okay? Sometimes they come, sometimes they don't. Who cares? Plan your time. Time planning is very important in this business. As you usually work from home, you might have more distractions and have no one like boss following how effective you on what you do. So you must be your own boss and follow your work as if you were at work. This is the ordinary time planning template that you can use for daily activity planning. Do planning detail for every day, every hour, hour by hour. Okay, so once you start filling templates like this, you clearly understand when is the time you made yourself a promise to do some certain work. And when you share it with your sponsor, asking him or her to keep an eye on your progress, so they would be the ones who would see how much tasks you raised yourself, and they would be able to help you to control your timing. This is very important. You do not want, you do not expect your sponsors to be those annoying people telling you what you have to do. You have to tell them what you decided to do. You have to ask for advice, okay? Once you get the advice, you send them your template and you ask them to help control you, okay? This is very, very important tip, and this is very effective. As working at home, we do not have any boss. So any help from outside, it usually makes this business much more effective. So work with your time management and ask your sponsor once again to follow up on your daily results. Controlling your time is very important skill for your business that many people underestimate. If you send your sponsor a message at the end of the day of what have you done for your business, this will make you much more efficient, okay? You will be ashamed to show the empty date. This was important to double check you understand this. Do your work systematically. When you plan your time, check if you haven't missed some important activities. Time for personal presentations, time for register new people and call them to webinars, trainings and presentations. Follow your numbers and always try to grow numbers of people attending webinars, presentations. Work with your team, do a periodical meetings with them. You can use Zoom, Skype meetings. This way is easy to reach everyone in any country, in any place, and it saves a lot of time to you. Get your partners involved to all trainings given by company. This is also very important. As a result of those steps, you will fast climb up in rank and will achieve great financial results. Invitations. Invitations is the first step that you will need to do with everyone on your contact list. And this skill is very important and you need a good preparation for it. For building mutual understanding and good relationship, we start from thinking positive about person we will talk with. So remember, you have 1, 2, 3 sentences you wrote compliments about every person on your contact list. Think how you set a quiet and comfort environment for your first calls. This is important for you to be fresh in your mind, not to be disturbed by anyone running around you. Also, make sure you do everything that person will be in a full comfort when you talk with him, no matter we speak offline or online. Phone call etiquette is something you must know and apply. If you must have and be ready to follow short scripts, which will help you to achieve your targets, do not worry to follow your script word by word. Be natural, but have a script just in case not to miss what you intended to talk about. Do not forget to show respect and care about person you speak with. Start with complimenting him, ask questions, and let person tell more about him and be ready to listen very well before you get the chance to say what you wanted. Remember, it's a person-to-person conversation that has to fit the circumstances and level of your relationship. So stay yourself in this conversation, stay authentic, okay? You choose a little bit different standard of talk, so you wouldn't be a stranger when you call your friend. You call the language you would normally call, you would normally talk with that friend, and if you call with your boss, you use the language you would normally talk with your boss, okay? So this is important. You do not follow some certain script blindly, because it makes some very, very strange mistakes, which look very, very strange from the outside to the people who know you. Talk slow and clear if person speaks slow, and try to speak faster if person speaks fast. So listen and use words and terminology person uses while talking with you. It's better you stand and smile when you speak on phone. This helps to express enthusiasm and positive emotions. Remember, this small tip is also lifting up efficiency of your phone calls a lot. Just standing, and sometimes if you are really want to make some point which truly makes difference, you can put your hand on your heart and it changes your tone. You would be surprised. This gesture is felt on opposite side of the phone, okay? So use those tips. Small tips are usually the most important ones. Be ready to hear and accept person telling you no, not interested, or even something rude. This just happens time to time. And you cannot fully know and imagine in what circumstances other person was at that moment. So just let it go, saying you will call some other time later, wish well to that person and make your next phone call to someone else. Okay? Just like this. So no matter what you were told, finish the phone call in a good and polite manner. Say, I thank you for your time spent to talk with me and I wish you well. After you finish your call, send all the material that you promised. You can send them by message or email. And now listen carefully again. If this makes no trouble to you, and if it is not damaging your conversation, be ready to send some material even during while you talk. The moment you talk, the moment you can send the material. This is very effective and gives you extra credits in your success. Okay, this comes from the top world salesman teachers. Okay, this strategy, it lifts an efficiency a lot. It might take you 100, 200 phone conversations until you feel absolutely free to make a phone call to any other prospect. And it's no other way to master this skill but by doing it. So enjoy this process, see how you grow your experience on the way. You can also count 100 no's, Okay, 100 no's means 100 rejections. When someone will tell, I don't want to hear this, this is not interesting, or something else. So try to count 100 no's. When you reach 100 no's, you are likely to become professional in networking. By reaching 1,000 no's, you will most likely be top paid professional in network industry. So you will love those no's that will bring you to your dream and financial success. When you talk to prospects, you want him to talk more than you do. Person feels good when someone is interested in them, so care about them. Ask open questions that normally could not be answered in one word. What person have heard about something? How person feels about something? What is his experience about something? Those questions will make person speak more and you will get more information. When finished, you can use effective tricks to get more information just by saying three last words that has been said and make a pause. Usually this technique would lead a prospect to speak again and answer your questions in more depth. Okay, so a little bit of psychological tricks, how you get more deep and more information out of your clients or prospects. Another trick is to say, it sounds like, it looks like, and you make a short conclusion of what was said by the person you talk with. Another way is to ask what person thinks about something, how person feels about something, what is his experience about something. Those questions will open much more information to you. The more you know about person, the more natural is for you to offer the solution of bringing your suggestions. Remember, no one cares of what you know unless they know how much you care about them. Closing questions on phone call are used to double check what you and person both understood. The main information same way. Did you understand same way? And double remind the agreements made among you. If you have used correct questions, at the end of the call, you will be confident that person understood you and have repeated and confirmed what you needed. That would mean a very good quality call. Okay, so you can, after you finish a call, you can always double check, rethink your call, what could be improved in a next call in the same situation, and you rethink if you have missed anything. This is the best way for you to learn. The best salesman tools is his ability to listen, express understanding. So repeat some of what was said, and when you repeat what was said, person understands that you listen, and it automatically suggests that you show you care about that person. Okay, this is very important. It builds a very, very strong relationship in this dialogue. Try not to take anything negative that was said to you. Stay positive and enthusiastic, optimistic. Everything must confirm that you are a nice to talk human and also a professional one. This is very important. Business conversation is next important step, and you need to be well prepared for it as well. Sponsor must help his partners to do it for a minimum first few times. This is also possible for both online and offline. Remember what is the most important rule? The first minutes of your business conversation. It's do not talk about yourself, do not tell about your products, do not tell about your services or your business. Remember, the main skill is the skill to question, the skill to compliment, and the skill to listen. But for business conversation, you must be ready in advance. Think of how you will look. Use business dress code. Always show respect to business you are in. And show the respect to person you meet. Do not judge the dress code of your prospect. He's the one who is allowed at that situation to be dressed in any style he wants. And you still need to have a good business look. Remember, you will be met by the way you look, and only when you will get a chance, only later you will get a chance to make impression of what you say. Seven steps to successful sale that you must try to follow in your business meetings. First, show client that investment is very smart and relevant step. Second, show your client the credibility side of how person could invest, suggest the safe way to invest and understand where the money goes. Third, question. So you would truly understand what person needs and person would understand you, would understand your offer comes fully understanding his situation. Okay, this is very important. Person internally feels he has given you the information needed for you to bring some suggestion. So do not overrush this stage. Fourth, tell main advantages of packages and tell how you see the future of the whole project. Share why you like it yourself, what others like in it the most. Fifth, by asking questions, you help to determine which package suits best to your client needs. Usually you want to start presenting the biggest packages. Go step by step, lower to lower packages, only when you fully understand that this is the best to your client, that this is the best for the start, to start with some smaller package. Then you step by one down. Do not rush to talk about small packages because usually they are far not the best suit for your clients. Six, do not underestimate. Only by questioning you must understand the financial health of your client. If any way, you must also show client the importance of the stage that company is currently in and what could be missed if not used a chance to buy more now. Okay, this is very important. People usually underestimate the possibility of their friends, of person they go to meeting with, they underestimate of their ability to buy much more. And by doing this, they do harm to their clients. So this is very, very important. You do not underestimate the possibility and you question. Number 7, tell step-by-step registration and end with call to action. You just say, let's do it right now together. I will stay with you. I will support you in future as well. So you are doing a smart step by setting your account and choosing a higher package. Okay, you bring encouragement, you bring support, and you bring compliments to the person for making this step. And you call to action, you do not delay yourself, okay? Because delaying, it's not only a damage for you, it's even a bigger damage to your client's needs. Your business conversation must be short, clear, and with some conclusions at the end. You can inquire at the beginning. If it's okay, if you will fit your full meeting, for example, in 1 hour or 45 minutes or 30 minutes, you can also think for the very beginning of your meeting if you can mention some other person that would raise your credibility. So maybe some person linked you together, or you can name someone client would trust. Okay, this is important to bring more power to yourself, because this way you can bring more value to customer. Ask prepared questions to understand needs of your client. Then offer the solution. Give argumentation work with your objections. Give argumentations, work with your objections, and focus to needs of your clients. Technique of double check questions. Questions to know if you got to the same conclusion, at same understanding of things you talk about. So this is also important to understand you are talking in the same language, same understanding. And you come to registration, so do registration, close the deal, and explain your further support on the following of business. For all steps, it's good to use an official marketing material done by company. Technique of closing. Every conversation leads your client to conclusion about sales. Do not oversell. Check time to time if you can close the deal by asking, how do you like the project? Did you hear enough to do registration and buy your package? Okay, you can, while doing your presentation, you can come to this question 2 or 3 times. Do not oversell. Sometimes people are already wanting to pay and someone sits and talks, sells the project. This question is very important. Did you hear enough to do registration and buy your package? Okay, if not, you go further on your presentation. You can use alternative questions, type of questions that both answers would be good to you. Shall we do registration first or look to packages? You would choose the best one for you. This usually suggests to choose one or another, but still go to the way you want to go, okay? There is no bad answer. Those questions, alternative questions, that both leads the way you want to go. This is one more trick you can have in your in your pocket. Remember, not one technique is the best, not one is possible. So the more you know, and the more you are able to apply. So knowledge, okay? You learn, you practice, and it's all better for yourself. Try to collect more yeses. This is also one of techniques before you go to closing questions. Would you agree we can do this now? Am I right that you are interested in this? Would you agree this is a nice way to invest? Would you agree it's best to do registration taking in mind I can help you with it right now? Okay, so questions might be different, prepared for the circumstances you are in, but the ones you already know that person agrees. So by just asking those questions, you kind of get person in a mood to accept to all that you suggest. Okay, one more important trick. Technique of Benjamin Franklin is an easy to use and very effective when you get stuck in a difficulty for client to take action. Okay, so it's kind of you did your job and you still see client cannot make a decision, cannot misses something to take the action. So we take a list, we divide it to two parts, advantages versus disadvantages. You write few important points on a side of advantages and you offer your client to tell you to name you disadvantages. If you only need, you also continue of adding more and more advantages on your side. So it's kind of a game. Which side collects more points? At some time you stop it and you count it. Which side has more and your side of advantages should normally be longer than opposite side. So if it is so, it should be a good reason to close the deal. Arguments are also on your side. Okay, this is also a nice trick to use. Compare your product with other investment products. Name some advantages and why it is best for your client. But you do not need to go too deep into analytics. As usually in networking, we keep it simple. So people in your team could do same presentations sometime in future. Okay? We do not go into overcomplication of presentation. They saying a salesman minus enthusiasm is just another clerk. So always keep positivity, enthusiasm and energy with yourself. Emotion is probably most important element that closes sales. Argumentation is one is only left to stand by that customer could justify his choice, telling it to someone else. But sales is led by emotion. You can become an owner of the best ever car, okay, in this industry of network marketing. But if you do not know how to drive it, it will give you a very little use and you will not, it will not take you too far. Learn how to make your trip more and more comfortable and effective. If you learn rules, tips and tricks, you will be able to teach your team to do what you do. It is worth trying. When you win, the world wins. Money will show up and follow you once you apply right action. Money comes when trust of client grows. And trust grows as you apply right steps of duplication. Same will be in your team. So do not worry, it might take you 6 months to master all steps. You will enjoy what you learn the rest of your life. First time you open conversation with any person, try to keep in an open format all the time. Ask if person allows you to reach him with the following useful information and tell it will be used just to inform about what might be the most important to him. After you have the permission, keep sending them to the following new information about project, its achievements. Special groups is very effective way to do this with more people. So you can help your clients to connect to team groups that have this type of information. Do not abuse this agreement. Do not spam to your clients. No matter if any person is interested, any person might know few other person that would be happy to get this information from you. And long contacts list and recommendations are very good to your business. So ask your client to recommend you to their friends. A happy client will do it with pleasure, but you must ask them for recommendations. Do not expect anyone to think for you and do anything for you if you did not ask for it. And when you get a recommendation of a happy client, this leads you to a much higher trust from the very beginning in your next conversation. You can ask, why would you recommend me to anyone else? Can you send me now some contacts of people you would believe to profit the most out of this information? Okay, so while you in the meeting, you can get the reason, and this will build your confidence if you ask the person. Tell me some reasons why would you recommend me to some of your friends. If they have the answer, you just ask for those friends. Your strategy and tactics must distinguish you from most other salesmen in network industry. So try to be more professional, more ethical, more understanding, and the one who truly cares about your clients. One more important thing I want to remind you. You must make a first call and invitation to webinar presentation. Then you follow up and arrange business meeting. It's very important to have it all done in short period of time. The faster follow-up, the higher its success rate. Success rate of follow-up after presentation of webinar, okay? One day you have a follow-up success of 70%. If you do it second to fourth day, it drops down to 23%. If you do it fifth to 10th day, your success rate statistically drops to 7%. So do not let your clients to cool down. There is no usually bad presentation or bad webinar, as most of success lies in follow-up. Okay, follow-up is very, very important. And this speed, how you attach presentation, webinar, a very fast follow-up can be the same day, can be next day, but you do not want to go from 70% to 7% or less. Yeah, you want to keep this 70% success rate. So you want to be fast. Argumentation and handling the objections. This is one more important subject. You need to practice and build your skills. Steps of professional argumentation. First, set the atmosphere of mutual understanding. Tell your story. Describe your situation. Be honest, authentic. How did you take this project from the very start yourself? Storytelling is the most effective way to attract and deliver the information. So use all the meetings with your teams. So you would hear a lot of different authentic stories, and then you can use them talking with your prospects. People listen to stories of others and find how they relate to them much faster than just by listening to facts. So try to collect stories and use them when you speak with prospects. Analyze how well client understood information given by you. This is question and listening, okay? Showing empathy and care. Double check your information was understood correct. Remember, very often some words are taken very different. Some words are very important, but might be understood in different ways. So double check will allow you to avoid mistakes. And of course, it will allow your clients to find the best way to do business and to do investment with you. Okay, most common objections. I have no money. I have no time. My wife or husband would not agree. This is pyramid. This will not make any profit, or all of it will disappear. Market is overloaded. The rule you must know about handling objections, that you do not argue with it. This is very important. Okay, listen, you do not argue. You take the objection. Show that you hear and you understand the point that was raised. You can say, I fully understand. the point you raised and repeat what was said. You know, I feel or I felt it the same way, or I know some people that thought about it same way. Okay, so this is important. You, once again, this person is not a stranger, okay, by raising some objections. We understand many of us passed over it. And you transition to story that would help you a lot by saying, let me tell you what I or what someone else found out about it. Okay, and you put story here. You just transition, okay, because you related, you showed the understanding, you showed that you listened to the person, okay, you acknowledge that this might be the point of view, and you just transition to showing someone else or yourself going through the same path and finding something else at the end. So this is very effective. Now you can show the other side and how it helped someone, okay? How people found other sides about getting more information, how they succeeded while being in the same situation. Networking is a business that does not require some very difficult skills. It requires not long time to learn and to start earning very good money. This industry proved many times to be best fit for millions of people in the world with different ages, different education, different backgrounds, and living in any spot of the world. So best way to know how people get the most in this industry is by listening to stories and later telling it to others. Remember, behind any argument, there are always standing some story, I would say. Next time we will learn, okay, something more. So I ask you to send questions, write what information you need to build big and strong team. We are here to support you and to help you. The best you can do to yourself is bring all your team to next training. Strong team is the key to your business success. Start practicing as practice and more practice is what will bring you the success. No rejection shall stop you. 1,000 rejections will bring you to the very top in networking industry. So remember, you win, the world wins. So we stay on touch and we meet on the following trainings.